You are not guilty.
I'm not guilty.
There is no possibility of rehabilitating a serial killer.
Well, I grabbed her by the neck and choked her until she died.
He was telling me that he likes to hurt him.
There is a genetic factor. The genetic factor leads to a predisposition.
I tried and failed and created a Holocaust.
The dead won't bother you. It's the living you gotta worry about.
My whole life I've been fascinated by serial killers, both in cinema and real life. I've watched slasher horror movies since I was 3 years old. I've read numerous books on serial killers, watched countless documentaries, forensic files hour after hour. The list just goes on. I'm enthralled with it. I don't know what the fascination is about. Maybe it's, you know, because they're so closely tied to death. As an atheist, we don't really talk about death too often. You know, when we're religious and stuff, we tend to talk about it a lot because we like to talk about the afterlife. But as atheists, we don't have an afterlife, so what is there to really talk about? But it is something scary, and, you know, like my friend Chris Evans actually brought the topic up, made a nice video about it a while back. You know, it's something that's very uncomfortable to people, and maybe that's why I have an interest in it, because it's a really uncomfortable topic. And, you know, it's the reason, basically, why 6 billion plus people in the world are religious. So maybe that's also part of the reason for my interest on the subject. I'm going to try something a little different in this video, and I'm just going to do it on a topic I like, really, and see how that goes. Hopefully you guys have an interest, you know, instead of me doing the usual on current events and Islam and Black Lives Matter and social justice, I'll throw it up with a little something interesting and actually is current, the case I want to talk about. Let's just get into it. Hopefully you guys can dig it. This case actually caught my eye and happened in August. It's about a 30-year-old woman who went jogging and was sexually assaulted and murdered. It interests me because it has the looks of like a regular, typical serial murder, but I don't believe any cases are actually tied to it, so it's hard to say at the moment. Shit like that always piques my interest, so I'm gonna be keeping my eye on the case, and they haven't caught a suspect yet, and I guess we'll just get into the details from the article here. More than a month ago, Karina Vetrano went for a run near her Howard Beach home. Her body was found a few hours later in a marshy area, strangled. Police said she had been sexually assaulted. In the days and weeks that followed, the community and Vetrano's family were left reeling. Police have received dozens of tips, and reward money raised has topped $275,000. But even as the tips roll in, police still haven't arrested the suspect. Here is a rundown of where the case currently stands. Vetrano, 30, went for a jog about 5 p.m. on August 2nd, a fairly common activity for her, police have said. During her run, investigators said Vetrano had been texting her best friend and the phone was swabbed for DNA. When she didn't return home that night, her family started getting worried. They began to search for her after she didn't return phone calls or texts and discovered her body about 4 hours later. She was found face down in a marshy area, about 15 feet from the trail near 161st Avenue and 78th Street in Spring Creek Park. In the days following, police recovered the DNA sample from Vetrano's neck, under her fingernails, and on cell phone, but were unable to match it to any known individual. It wasn't in any of the databases. Chief of Detective Robert Boyce has said police spoke to several people involved in her personal life, including her ex-boyfriend, who is not a suspect. Investigators also reviewed surveillance video in the area, but haven't found any video evidence at all to show anybody lingering. Police shifted the investigation toward Brooklyn in late August to determine if the attacker could have escaped the park westbound along the Belt Parkway. So the Belt Parkway is this stretch of highway that runs around Brooklyn and Queens, along the coast, on the water, and it just goes around the edge, basically, of the two boroughs. Yeah, by the way, that's the girl that got killed. She's incredible. Unfortunate. That's misogynistic of me. Oh my God. On August 18th, Vetrano's father said police were close to catching the killer, appealed to the family of the suspect, and urged them to take the reward money raised, according to multiple media reports, but Police Commissioner Bill Bratton said that wasn't true and reiterated his appeal to any members of the public for help closing the case. On August 31st, police released a sketch of a possible witness to the murder. Boyce said the individual is not considered a suspect, but hoped he may have more information about the incident. The sketch spurred more tips, but police still don't have a suspect. We're looking for a break, Boyce said in an interview with Crime Watch Daily, which I have clips here we'll look at in a minute. We need a break in the case. On September 21st, Boyce said he's optimistic that investigators will find Vetrano's killer. I think we will make an arrest in the case, he said. Police have received more than 170 calls in the case, and those, Boyce said, 12 tips remain open for investigation. So this girl usually goes jogging with her father, but her father wasn't feeling good, so he didn't go with her. And she goes out for a jog, and we see in the footage here her jogging along, and that's the only footage they have. This is probably about a minute before she goes into the trails. Now, you saw those weeds there. There's just trails along these weeds in the highway along the Bell Parkway, and they're all over. I've ridden them with my bike before. I've walked through them. They're all over the place, Brooklyn and Queens. So there's weeds on either side of the trail, and they're really like 10 feet high. They're just, it's thick and dense back there if you're not on the trail, so anyone could just hide back there. So it's always probably been a dumping ground for bodies and stuff like that in Brooklyn, amongst other places. But it's just really creepy to have that out here, and you hope it's not a serial killer, and you hope that they catch the dude, because it just fucking sucks to have that going on in the neighborhood, especially for women, you know. I talk about anti-feminism, shit like that, but I'm still a fucking, an actual human being. I care for people. So obviously, you know, women are going to be the target if the guy's a rapist, so. And it just sucks for the community and everyone involved. It's a horrible incident, and the parents. I'm going to show you a clip now with the parents, just to, you know, pull that emotional string of yours and get you involved a bit. But it's also going to go into a little part of why I find this case interesting, because, you know, is it a serial killer, or is it someone that is related to them or related to her in any way? Because they really are unsure, and they've cleared many of the family members, so it's just a really fucking bizarre case, and it's up in the air right now, so take a look.
4 hours after Phil's phone calls, pings from Karina's cell phone led him and police to Karina.
You found your daughter.
I did. With the help of the PD.
As a parent, I have a hard time even getting my arms around that.
I think as a parent, you would rather you find your child than someone else. It's the last act of protection you can give your child.
Karina, a talented 30-year-old who earned a master's degree in speech pathology, also starred in this art house film based on a poem she wrote called The Paradox. Her family says everybody loved Karina, and she was such a social butterfly, she even texted while she was jogging. And Detective Boyce reveals Karina actually texted just before she was attacked.
The motive was sexual assault, and this was a random attack.
We are confident, but we're not closing out anything in this case, whether it be her private life or whatever. Thus far, nothing has revealed that.
This is a police sketch of a man in a wool cap they want to talk to, who is in the location around the time the raven-haired runner was killed.
And any luck with the sketch of the guy seen on the edge of this park?
We have about 25 calls on him, and we're vetting each one of them to come in.
But you don't know whether he's a suspect or...
Right now, he's not even a person of interest. He's out there. He could be a witness.
Chief Detective Boyce also let me in on something else, telling me NYPD has scoured the area to collect every surveillance video they could get their hands on.
That's hours and hours of video.
It is. We put up a private room, and we assigned police officers and detectives just to watch that, to see if they saw any kind of activity at all.
Anything come out of that?
Nothing.
To date, with the hundreds of hours of video police have viewed, these are the only images of Karina they've seen so far.
Does the video give you any clues as to what happened to her? Does the video give you any clue as to who may have done this to her?
It does not. And that's one of the reasons that I got into where we are now with the case. So we went from all the way over here all these homes here and collected video. Could possibly be help us probative video showing anybody entering and leaving the park. Quite a substantial undertaking.
You've got a $300,000 reward. You've got DNA. You've got some of the most experienced detectives in the nation working this case, yet you don't have much to go on at this point.
No. We went through the entire investigation, and now we're seeking the public's help.
Can you give me a criminal profile of this attacker?
I cannot, because all we have is the DNA. It doesn't reveal anything else other than that, other than it's a male.
This is going to be seen around the country. What message do you have for people?
We're looking for a break. We need a break in the case.
Well, hopefully they will find the person who murdered this girl and give the family some closure, because things like this are just terrible. But I love delving into this, and hopefully when they find out who it is, then I get to do what I really like, which is delve into the psyche of the serial killer or whoever he may be. You know, people like Albert Fish and Jeffrey Dahmer and shit like that, they're fascinating to me. I just wanted to bring that to you guys and, you know, let you pick apart the brain of Billy Bong a little more. And hopefully you don't think I'm too crazy. Have a good one.
They know, and they know that I didn't do these things.
You are not guilty.
I'm not guilty. Does that include the time I stole a comic book when I was 5 years old? I'm not guilty of the charges which have been filed against me.
And the allegations?
And the allegations.
And the rumors. And the
I don't know all of what you're speaking about, Lucky. It's too broad and I can't get into it in any detail. But I'm satisfied with my blanket statement that I'm innocent. No man is truly innocent. I mean, we all have transgressed in some way in our lives. And as I say, I've been impolite, and there are things I regret having done in my life. But nothing like the things I think that you're referring to.
Have you ever physically harmed anyone?
Ever physically harmed anyone? No. No. You know, again, not in the context of things that you're speaking of.